Good morning, students. Today in economics we are going to revise lesson number 1, the story of village Palampur. In today's video we are going to learn more about organization of production, which includes land, labor, physical capital and human capital. We will also learn about farming in Palampur. Let's begin. The purpose of the story is to introduce some basic concepts relating to production. So through the story of village Palampur, we are going to learn some basic concepts relating to production. Let's begin. Farming is the main activity in Palampur, whereas several other activities such as small-scale manufacturing, dairy, transport, etc. are carried out on a limited scale. So it is very clear, students. Farming is the main activity in Palampur, whereas several other activities like transport, small-scale manufacturing, dairy, etc. are also carried out but on a limited scale. Okay. These production activities need various types of resources. For example, natural resources, man-made items, human effort, money, etc. So to carry out production activities, we require various types of resources like natural resources, man-made items, human effort, money, etc. Is that clear, students? Palampur is well connected with neighboring villages and towns. Raiganj, a big village, is 3 kilometers from Palampur. Raiganj is a big village, which is 3 kilometers away from Palampur. An all-weather road connects the village to Raiganj and further on to the nearest small town of Shahpur. Shahpur is a small town. Okay, and Palampur is well connected with neighboring villages and towns, which means Palampur is well connected with Raiganj as well as small town of Shahpur. Is that clear, students? Many kinds of transport are visible on this road, starting from bullock carts, tongas, bogies, that is wooden cart drawn by buffaloes, loaded with jaggery and other commodities, to motor vehicles like motorcycles, jeeps, tractors and trucks. So here in village Palampur, we find various kinds of transport like bullock carts, tongas, bogies, motorcycles, jeeps, tractors and trucks. Here in this image, you can see jeep, truck, motorcycle and tractor. This village has about 450 families belonging to several different castes. So how many families are there in the village Palampur? Yes, 450 families, and they belong to several different castes. The 80 upper caste families own the majority of land in the village. How many upper caste families are found in the village Palampur? Yes, 80 upper caste families, and they own the majority of land in the village. Their houses, some of them quite large, are made of brick with cement plastering. So what about the houses of the upper caste families? Yes, some of them are quite large and they are made up of brick with cement plastering. Okay. Now let us talk about the scheduled caste people. Okay. The scheduled caste, that is Dalits, comprise 1/3 of the population and live in one corner of the village and in much smaller houses, some of which are of mud and straw. What about the houses of the scheduled caste people? Yes, it is small and made up of mud and straw. So students, you need to remember the difference between the houses of upper caste people and the scheduled caste people living in the village Palampur. The houses of upper caste quite large and made up of brick and plastered with cement, whereas the houses of scheduled caste people quite small and made up of mud and straw. I hope you will remember this. Most of the houses have electric connections. Okay, electricity powers all the tube wells in the fields and is used in various types of small business. So most of the houses in the village Palampur have electric connections and electricity powers all the tube wells in the fields and it is used in various types of small business. Is that clear, students? Palampur has two primary schools and one high school. So how many primary school and high school in the village Palampur? Yes, Palampur has got two primary schools and one high school. There is a primary health center run by the government and one private dispensary where the sick are treated. So we have primary health center run by the government as well as one private dispensary where the sick people are treated. Is that clear, students? So it is very clear that Palampur has fairly well-developed system of roads, transport, electricity, irrigation, schools and health center. Now let us learn about the types of activities in Palampur. There are two types of activities in Palampur: farm activities and non-farm activities. Shopkeeping, transport, small-scale manufacturing are few examples of non-farm activities in the village Palampur. Now let us talk about the organization of production. Organization of production includes land, labor, physical capital and human capital. There are four requirements for production of goods and services. Okay, the first requirement is land. We also require some other natural resources such as water, forest, minerals. The second requirement for the production of goods and services is labor. Some production activities require fully qualified workers and highly educated workers to perform necessary tasks. For example, doctor, engineer, teacher, etc. Other activities require workers who can do manual work. For example, worker at the construction site. But in every activity, labor is vital. For every activity, we require labor. Okay. Now let us learn about physical capital. Okay, this is the third requirement for the production of goods and services. Physical capital include fixed capital and working capital. Okay, let us learn more about this. Tools, machines and buildings can be used in production over many years. Isn't it, students? Once you purchase tools, machines and buildings, you can use it in production activity for many years. Okay. Tools and machines range from very simple tools such as a farmer's plow to sophisticated machines. Now here in this image you can see fixed capital. Buildings, machines can be used in production purpose for many years. Now tools and machines range from very simple tools such as farmer's plow to sophisticated machines. Sophisticated machines means complicated machines. Generators, turbines, computers are few examples of sophisticated machines. Now let us learn about working capital. Production requires a variety of raw materials like yarn used by the weaver. Here in this image you can see yarn used by the weaver. Clay used by the potter. We also require money for the production purpose. So raw materials and money, okay, they are the working capital. Working capital gets used up in the production activity. Okay, So what is the difference between fixed capital and working capital? Fixed capital, we can use it in production for many years. Okay. Whereas working capital, they get used up in the production activity. I hope it is clear, students. For example, we will take the example of a potter. The clay the potter uses for making pots is a raw material, right? It is the working capital. It gets used up in making pots, isn't it? Whereas the wheel, it is a fixed capital, as the potter can use the wheel for many years. So I hope it is clear, students. You all understood fixed capital and working capital. Okay, let us move further. Now let us learn about human capital. Human capital is the fourth requirement in the production of goods and services. Do you all know why is human capital important? Let us try to find out the answer. We will need knowledge and enterprise to be able to put together land, labor and physical capital. Isn't it, students? Human capital is required to put together land, labor and physical capital so that we can obtain output. So every production is organized by combining land, labor, physical capital and human capital. Is that clear, students? And this land, labor, physical capital and human capital are known as factors of production. I hope you all have understood about the factors of production. Students, now let us learn about farming in Palampur. Land is fixed. Farming is the main activity in Palampur. We have already learned that farming is a main activity in Palampur. 75% of the people who are working are dependent on farming for their livelihood. They could be farmers or farm laborers. Okay. Land area under cultivation is fixed. Since 1960 in Palampur, there has been no expansion in land area under cultivation. By then, some of the waste lands in the village had been converted to cultivable land. Here in this image you can see some of the waste lands been converted to cultivable land. There exists no further scope to increase farm production by bringing new land under cultivation. Why is it so, students? Because some of the wastelands in the village had been converted to cultivable land. So there is no further scope to increase farm production by bringing new land under cultivation. Is that clear, students? So I hope you all have understood the topics covered today. Now it's quiz time. I hope you all are ready for the quiz. Question number 1. Which of the following is a factor of production? Option A, land. Option B, labor. Option C, physical capital. Option D, all of these. Yes, which is the correct answer? Once again, which of the following is a factor of production? Option A, land. Option B, labor. Option C, physical capital. Option D, all of these. Yes, the correct answer is option D, all of these. Because land, labor, physical capital, these all are factor of production. Now let's move on to the next question. Money in hand is an example of option A, human capital. Option B, fixed capital. Option C, working capital. Option D, physical capital. Yes, which is the correct answer? Once again, I'll repeat the question. Money in hand is an example of option A, human capital. Option B, fixed capital. Option C, working capital.
Option D, physical capital. Yes. The correct answer is option C, working capital. Money in hand is an example of working capital. Very good. Next question. Which one among the following is not a fixed capital? Option A, machines. Option B, buildings. Option C, tools. Option D, raw materials. Yes. Which is the correct answer? Once again, I'll repeat. Which one among the following is not a fixed capital? Okay. Machines, buildings, tools, raw materials. And the correct answer is option D, raw materials. Raw materials is not a fixed capital, whereas machines, buildings, tools, they are the examples of fixed capital. Is that clear, students? Next question. Which of the following transformed the system of irrigation in Palampur? Option A, tube wells. Option B, Persian wheel. Option C, rainwater harvesting. Option D, none of these. Yes, which is the correct answer? Once again, I'll repeat the question. Which of the following transformed the system of irrigation in Palampur? Option A, tube wells. Option B, Persian wheel. Option C, rainwater harvesting. Option D, none of these. And the correct answer is option A, tube wells. Okay. Very good. Now let us do a short recap. Today in this video, we have learnt about the organization of production. Land, labor, physical capital and human capital. We also learnt about farming in Palampur. Farming in Palampur will be continuing in our next video. Okay, I hope you all have understood the topics covered today. Don't forget to read the textbook. Meet you in the next video. Till then, bye and take care.